this background is crazy. I should probably put both fairy lights on. It's Bulbasaur. I love him. Okay, so today we're gonna do a super chill, super cozy, super quiet. It's 11 o'clock at night, but I got this package today in the mail. So I thought that I would open it and share it because I haven't done a video in a while and people love unboxings. Okay, so this is a very conspicuous box. And it's from a subscription service called Freya's Cauldron. It's a Wicca subscription service. I'm just covering my address. A Wicca subscription service that they send you all sorts of stuff that you need for Wicca. I feel like it might be quite Yule themed because it's Yule in a couple of weeks. And it's all witchy stuff. And that's cool. So here's something actually that I got in a different one. I got this book in one of my other Wicca ones. It's where I write down all of my Wicca information. This is a cool drawing. Cool, right? Sorry about the change of setup. I am changing the angle a bit because it's the middle of the night, so I can't use the sunlight, so I thought I would use my little light that I use for my makeup. And you have a different backdrop. This is my bed. Shout out to one of my best friends for being on my t-shirt today. Don't run with scissors, kids. Sprint instead. Oh, I'm super excited. Like, I really don't need any more Wicca stuff. But you can honestly never have too much, can you? Oh, gosh. Okay, so, this is from Freya's Cauldron. Witchcraft, supplies, and gifts. The Spellkeeper's Chest. Welcome to our December description box. Here we are again in the wonderful month of Yule. Such a wonderful time for celebration. Our box this month is part two of the Yule boxes and includes a few more useful items for your activities and celebrations. So here's what we have for you this month. They have a bunch of, like, things that tell you what it is. So first thing we have is a Yule card. Like a Christmas card, but a Yule card. Pardon me. And it's got this cool dragon with a tree and a lady and a star. And then it says, Feliz Navidad, Feliz de Yuletide, Joyous Noel, something else, Yuletide greetings. There's an envelope here with a dragon on it, and a face. A bunch of packing pasta. It sticks together if you lick it. My friend made this. It's apparently a coral out of these. Ah! Oh! I'm so excited. Okay, so I know what this one is. These are Guatemalan worry dolls. I actually have a little pot up there. Ooh! My little yellow pot is a little box of worry dolls I got from Texas in the USA. I just love worry dolls. I used to have them all the time when I was a kid. So it says here, it's this little thing here, it says, there is a story that when Mayan people of Guatemala had worries, they would tell them to their worry dolls and put them under their pillow at night. By morning, worry dolls would have taken the worries away. I just think these are so cute, and they're all handmade, and they're all... And it comes in a cute little bag. So cute, I'm excited about these. Come our little pretties. Oops, sorry, dude. Oh, we have loads. Okay, so this one, it comes with 6 little worry dolls. This is what they look like. And they are all different colours and shapes and sizes. Well, not sizes, they're all different designs. Very cute. That is so cute. I'm so happy with those. That's really cute. So this one, we have a Blessed Be pendant. I love this. I can see already what it is. Okay, so it comes with a little chain. And then it has the charm. I'm going to wear this right now. Okay, so it's this little Blessed Be charm. It has a pentagram at the top. It says Blessed Be on it. It says the same thing on the other side. That is so cute. I'm actually so happy with this. If any of you are interested in getting one of these subscription boxes, I will put all the links in the description so that you can go and get one for yourself. I'd honestly recommend it, especially if you are getting into the Wicca faith, because it's given me so much just to start out with. So it keeps you going. Like, it usually has candles in it for spells, provides the spells and how to do them. So it has all the things like you need to start your journey and as to becoming a Wicca, and it's also just very good to get supplies and cute new things that you might need. So there's that one. I think that's so cute. Okay, so the next thing in this little package is a pink opal stone, and this is a beautiful little stone. It's a pink one. How do I do this? Where's my paper? This pink lovely opal stone, and I'm sure it has lots of magical properties for it. It'll be great for how you're feeling and different spells. And each of these comes with a little book, and this one has in it all the things that it needs. So shows you the energy, the planet, the element, chakra, and the astrological signs. And it then tells you all the different descriptions of what sort of thing it can help you with, and like what sort of spells it can be used for, and that's very nice. It's also a very lovely stone, just to add to my nice stone collection. Ooh, so next up we have a little fragrance bottle. These are really good for spells because they smell and you can use them for all sorts of stuff. I'm very big at oil burners, I love them. And this one is myrrh, and it really reminds me of that vine where he goes, "I brought you myrrh, thank you, murder." Jesus, no! Ooh! It's quite. Smells like pine mixed with a little bit of menthol. I like it. But that is myrrh. I'm gonna put this with my oil collection as well. More packing pasta! Okay, so the next thing that I saw was this little cute little, magnet, and it's got got these ravens on them, chilling, being dudes. That's super cute. I'm gonna put that on my fridge downstairs, whether my family like it or not. Okay, so next we have 3 little bags of herbs. These are super great for spells. I sadly haven't got into herb magic yet. I'm not very good at the spells and stuff. I'm really just only starting out. But it's good to keep the collection growing. So we've got plantain, which smells very nice. We've got raspberry leaf, which smells even nicer. And then we have some cloves, which smell very strong. So those are really good. And in my little like book here, with all the information, it does have things that tell you what you have and how to use them and what to do with them. Next up is something I actually already own, but this seems to be a much bigger bottle. It's a lemongrass fragrance oil. And this goes in an oil burner. And lemongrass is a lovely smell. It's one of my favourite ones I actually have. So that's really cool, actually really useful. And I'm sure that it's actually really, really cool to find, to have this, even though I already have it, to have more of it. And hopefully it will have some form of ingredients for a spell so then I can use it. And I know that what I already have and use is what is actually used for in the Wicca community, so that's really, really cool having that. I'm not entirely sure why, but we have a bunch of little tongs, which is very interesting. I'm sure this will become clearer later. Okay, so we have some spell candles. We have some red, green, and white ones, and these are just completely plain candles, and they are very good to just keep around. For certain spells, each candle is different in different meanings. They have different feelings behind them, different intentions. So it's good to have the collection building. I already have red, orange, and black, and I also have some white ones, and I also have some more. So this is really good to keep the collection growing and making sure I have all the different colours. Okay, so this one here is a Yule Fire spell, and it comes with the spell, and it comes with some leaves and a candle. And this is a spell kit, so these are really great because they come with all the ingredients you need. Inside it will tell you what you need to do and what you need to do with the ingredients. It will tell you all of the different things. So what you'll need is a red pen and a sheet of white paper, and then you read the thing and do what it says, and your spell is done, and hopefully it will give off some good vibes and good luck and all sorts. So that one's really, really cool. Ooh, I think these are bath bombs. Maybe that's what the tongs are for. Like, pick them up. I'm not entirely sure what these are. I'm going to have a look. So let's look at our little thing we have. Okay, so in our paper we also have a nice little greeting from the creators of the box. They say thank you for subscribing, thank you for getting our box. We have the 12 herb Yule sachet. Oh, this is how to, it's like an ingredients list to make a Yule herb sachet. Cleansing and consecrating tools. So how to cleanse your tools and make sure that they're good and nice for magic. We have a Yule ritual, and then the descriptions of all the things. So let's have a look. Oh, the tongs are for something else. Ooh, okay. I'm not entirely sure, it doesn't say. Okay, right. Oh my gosh. This is heavy. Oh my god, this is so cool. Bloody hell. Oh my god. This is stunning. This is a really heavy, apparently it's a cast iron cauldron for all of your spell needs, and oh my god, this is so stunning. I'm so pleased with this. This is so amazing. That's so stunning. I was just having a quick read in here, and it says, cast iron. This month we have decided to include a lovely pot-bellied cauldron. Quite a high-priced item, but as it is the time of giving, we thought it was a good choice. We hope you will agree. Now I know some of you will already own a cauldron, but in my opinion, you can never have too many. I have four working cauldrons of various sizes and sometimes use at least two at a time. One will burn incense or offerings, other will have a specially dressed offering candle. Other times I'll use both for burning if I feel I need more than one. They are such useful and versatile items to have around. I have one just like this in which I keep some of my damaged crystals, sort of retirement home for them. Yes, I know, quite sad. This is so beautiful. And then the next thing that comes with it is we have these two charcoal discs and some frankincense resin. And it says underneath, if you plan to use your cauldron for burning the burning of incense or, and offerings, you probably need charcoal discs. They are useful to have in stock, so you've put a couple into cute reusable pots to get you going. It is important to remember to stay safe when using charcoal discs, so you've included a set of tongs so you can use the handle to lift the handle to avoid burning yourself. Oh, how nice. To add to your collection of incense supplies, we have supplied a pot of frankincense resin. This is a wonderful resin to add when is often added to other magical mixtures to increase their potency due to the powerful vibrations of energy that are released when it's burned. These intense energies drive away negative energies and evil. But that is amazing. I'm so happy with this. I just love it. It's so heavy. You put that over here. And then you get these cute little pots. And some charcoal discs as well to burn in your cauldron. So I think that is everything inside the Freya's cauldron this month. And oh my god, were we spoiled. There is so much nice things. Just, oh. I'm absolutely spoiled, honestly. I'm so happy with all of it. And this this subscription box, I think, is only £25. So lots of the stuff I've received is worth quite a bit more than that. Or is worth a lot in itself. And I'm very, very pleased with it, honestly. And you get a box and you get some packing pasta to make stuff too. I might show you some more about my Wicca journey in the future, as it is super interesting and I'm new to it and it's a very interesting topic to talk about, I feel. So yeah, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna play with all my new toys and read up about all of it and be very excited. I hope you enjoyed this video. It was very lazy and chilled and laid back and crazy. I hope that it wasn't too bad. I hope that the setup wasn't too crazy or my bookshelf isn't too distracting. I have a lot on it. I might start using this setup more often. It's much easier to set up and start filming, as my windowsill is usually quite full of stuff, but we'll see what happens in the future. But I hope you enjoyed this video. Please check out my other videos, subscribe to this channel, like it, comment, do the YouTubery stuff, and I will see you soon. Bye!